Agave is a liquid sweetener extracted from a plant, and it has a low glycemic index, which means it doesn't spike your blood sugar. So why would I say that it is not an acceptable sugar substitute? I explain in this video. Agave is an abbreviated name, so you might have heard of it referred to as agave nectar or agave syrup. And this syrupy liquid is extracted from the agave plant, but not very easily. So extraction requires heat and processing, and while that produces this sweet liquid, it also kills most of the beneficial compounds from the original plant. So you're not getting a great deal of nutrient value from processed agave nectar. Yet agave has gained favor with dieters who are looking for alternatives for sugar because it has a low glycemic index. Now, the glycemic index is a scale that ranks foods according to how much they impact your blood sugar. And while this is a bit oversimplified, generally speaking, the higher the glycemic index, the worse the food is for your waistline, because a high glycemic index equals a big rise in blood sugar, which equals a rise in insulin, which puts your body in a fat storing mode. Since agave has a lower glycemic index than sugar, it should be better for dieters. Unfortunately, that is not the case because of the blend of sugars that we find in agave syrup. Most of agave's sweetness comes from fructose, not glucose. Now, glucose and fructose are molecules that look very similar on paper, but to your body, they look very different, and therefore they are treated much differently. Glucose is a primary source of energy, and virtually every cell in your body can take it in and burn it as fuel, but that's not the case for fructose. In fact, the only organ that can metabolize fructose is your liver. And while your liver can turn a bit of that fructose into glycogen, which is a stored form of glucose, it turns most of it into fat. And that fat either stays in your liver and contributes to a fatty liver, which is a condition I covered in a previous video, or it is packaged up and sent out into the blood, which increases blood triglycerides. So concentrated fructose, like we see in agave, is not a friend to your health or your weight. And just to give you an idea of the fructose content, depending on the brand of agave syrup, it can be as high as 90% fructose, whereas the fructose content of high fructose corn syrup is around 55%. So agave is a more concentrated source of fructose than even high fructose corn syrup, which is a sweetener that is widely recognized as a health hazard. Now, in case you're wondering about honey, I will cover that sweetener in next week's video. And I have discussed other sugar substitutes on my channels. I even tested how they affected my blood glucose and ketones on my YouTube channel that I share with my husband. So I will link to those videos so that you can check those out. But if your goal is weight loss, my advice about adding sweeteners of any type is still the same, and that is relying on sugar substitutes makes it hard for your taste buds and brain to move away from their need for sweetness, and that makes it harder, in my opinion, to stick with your diet. So I'll just leave you with the thought that there is life on the other side of sugar. If you need help, I encourage you to watch my free video series and learn my 0-1-2-3 strategy. The series contains 4 videos and more than 40 minutes of content that is not found here on YouTube. So check that out. Please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you back here next week. Thanks.